Sometimes I wish you took care of yourself better. It hurts myself seeing you like this, Izuku. And it's not that I don't support you by saying this, I do. With all of my heart I do, but seeing you like this, with all these scars. It terrifies me so much. Inko rants as she slowly strokes the scars on Izuku's hand, her breath sniffling softly as warm tears drop from her face. She looks at her son who didn't dare to bat her in the eye. She could tell he was struggling from everything that has been going on lately. Personally for her, it's just a mother's instincts to scold their child if they hurt themselves or push through their limits for the good of other people. It broke her heart. She didn't want for a day when Izuku is locked up inside a hospital not knowing when or if he would wake up. Although knowing about the risks about being a hero, I guess you can't really push that feeling away from a mother's caring heart. Izuku felt really sorry, he never wanted to see his mum crying. He slowly embraced her with his arms, burying his face on the crook of her neck. I'm sorry, mum. Please don't cry. I'm so mad at you, Izuku. I know, you have the right to. I don't know, mum, you know how it's like being a hero. That doesn't mean it gives you the right to break your bones every time I get the chance to see you. I know, mum, I'm sorry. I should have thought about it, but I was in a really tight situation. Please stop crying, I promise I'll take care of myself for the better. You should keep your words, because the next time I see you like this, I wouldn't know what to do. Inko presses a kiss on his forehead, examining her teary son's eyes. She looks at him so dearly, it's been such a long time since they met. You know, I wish I had been there for you. You're safe here, mum, I really can't imagine anything happening to you. You really promise, Izuku? Yay, I don't like seeing you cry anymore. Something about this conversation made him feel really horrible inside. Maybe he would put up a wall because he didn't want his mum to see him in his most vulnerable state after seeing her like that. It did question everything about himself though. Izuku doubted himself. Why couldn't he be stronger? Midoriya, your recent reports have been quite concerning. Is everything okay? Izuku looked down the floor, mind already daydreaming to escape the day. Sometimes it just feels so long, he wanted it to be over. Midoriya. Yes sir. Everything has been alright I suppose, there's nothing to worry about. I wonder what All Might and Ectoplasm has been talking about lately. They said you haven't been able to control your quirk well enough, you do know the exams are coming soon? I do know that. And they did? Yes, they've been noticing some irregular patterns of your quirk activation and control. I hope you will be improvising on that soon. I will, sir. Sorry for causing inconvenience for the teachers. It's alright. You haven't been causing inconvenience, Midoriya, everyone learns at their own pace. I think they're saying this because the control over your one for all used to have a better progress. I see, maybe I've just been distracted lately. Yeah, and you will be able to improve on that, I'm assuming? Of course. Izuku walked out of the classroom, a frown quickly appearing on his face. He shut the door as he leaned slowly on it, spacing out again. Of course, there had been complaints about his recent performance. He didn't really know what was happening to him. He couldn't describe it, but one thing was sure that he didn't feel good at all. Bakubro, what's up? Nothing, shitty hair. You haven't been screaming like you used to. I mean it's good, but it's definitely not the most Bakugo thing to do. You want me to scream at your ear then? That's not what I said. Kirishima covers his eardrums after the loud scream Bakugo gave on his ears. His face was now back to his usual Bakugo scowl, something Kirishima has been fond of. But he knew something had definitely been going on, almost as if he was observing something from afar. Shitty hair, do you know why the nerd stayed back in class after school ended? No idea, what's wrong? Is someone concerned? Smirking face. Kirishima gives him a smug smirk, nudging on his shoulders as Bakugo gets irked by him even more. Do you want me to scream at your ear again? No sir. No sir. He looks away, hands nervously brushing through his hair. But seriously though, I have no idea. Maybe the others know? Ask his group of friends or something. TCH. Why are you scoffing? Why are you complaining so much? Nothing, I'm just thinking that you have too much pride to talk to those extras. I do. Shut up, Bakugou. Kirishima rolls his eyes as he walks in a fast pace, scared to face him again. Did you just? Shitty hair. Bakugou huffs in annoyance as he gazes back on the clock. He didn't have the time to pick up an argument with anyone right now. There was only one thing on his mind lately. What's up with Deku? It's 9 p.m. Bakugou keeps flipping around his bed trying to sleep. No matter how hard he tried, he felt like both sides of his pillows were hot. Which was undeniably uncomfortable. He grunts, his signature grimace now sitting on his face. He's been thinking a lot lately. The conversation he had with Kirishima was a couple hours ago. Deku hadn't arrived at the dorm from 7. His observations seemed to vex him even more, because the last time Bakugou caught him entering back the dorm was at 11 p.m. God knows he was doing what. Nonetheless, he really didn't want to admit it, but it was genuinely concerning him. Bakugou looks back at the clock, 9:32. Had he really been spending 32 minutes tossing from one side of another and contemplating about checking on him or not? He gets up, taking the elevator to the lounging area. One thing he would know for sure if people had arrived at the dorm was that their shoes would be placed on the shoe rack Yue had provided. He walked over to check the shoes, seeing that Aizuku's rack was empty. Is that nerd actually serious? It's almost 10 p.m. on a school night. What the fuck is he doing outside? At first it was okay for the first 3 days, he didn't want to be the type of person to push his boundaries and force him to tell him what was wrong. But it has been irritating him so much lately because he kept coming home late, barely answering texts, and has been seen spacing out so much in class and practices. Seriously, how can he not be concerned? Bakugou grabs his phone out of his pocket, quickly reaching out to his boyfriend's number, dialing it 1 minute, he wasn't picking up. Bakugou didn't give up, trying a couple more times till it led to his voicemail. His soft voice rang. Hey? I'm currently not available right now, either text me or leave a voicemail. Sorry. Bakugou puts his hand over his forehead, quietly flopping himself on the couch nearby. He grunts again, contemplating whether or not to grab a hoodie and search for him. He slaps himself inside the head. Dumbass, why would you question that? Of course you search for him. What kind of boyfriend are you? He quickly goes back to his room, grabbing a hoodie and walks out of the dorm. It was freezing out here, how is he seriously not yet back home? Bakugou's first initial plan was to search around the school. Sometimes you see him roam around the park. He wouldn't have gone anywhere far, the school doesn't let its students do that. Deku. Are you fucking serious? I've been searching around for you for an hour straight. It's 11 p.m. Why aren't you back? Bakugou leaves an angry voicemail as he keeps walking around the school, trying to find him. Deku, pick up the fucking phone. Please. He was wretched at this point, it was freezing cold outside. The snow had been building up from December, the winter hasn't gone yet. By now it was near 12 a.m. when the idea of Deku coming back passed his head. Bakugou was really tired, he didn't know how much laps he walked around the school, trying to search for him in all places. And to add, have I emphasized it enough, it's less than 0 degrees. Bakugou can only hope for him to be back, still a heavy feeling growing inside his heart because he knew something was going on. He regret not approaching him sooner because Aizuku usually handled his bad moods maturely, but this has gone completely out of control. I swear, Deku, if you're still not bar. He sees his red sneakers placed on the rack. He heaves out a heavy sigh, glad that he's back. The question is he in his room? Would it be bad to pay a small visit? Bakugou decides to check every area of the dorm anyway, because he was cautious and worried. He probably was either super exhausted causing him to be delusional, but he did hear small sobs coming from the lounging area. Maybe not. Bakugou walked inside the lounging area, only to see his presumed adorable boyfriend wrapped inside a blanket, as he smooshed his face against the pillows. He heard the quiet whimpers. The blonde was a little bit shaken, because he didn't really know how to deal with people crying and comforting them. I usually just say stop crying or get killed. But this is Deku. How do I comfort people standing person with light skin tone? He reached out his hand to the frail green-haired boy, gently brushing through his hands that weren't wrapped inside the fabric. Deku felt his touch and jumped, almost whisper screaming his way to fall down from the sofa. Kachin? Kachin. He starts crying again, more aggressively this time. Bakugou obviously starts panicking because he was none other than confused and was partially blaming himself for the cause of him crying more. Why the hell are you crying? Oh, I promise I it's nothing. I just don't feel good today. Don't worry about it. Just go to sleep, I'll keep quiet. You are such a dumbass.
I am?
Yeah, that's right, yeah. Yeah, well, you're not exactly wrong. Bakugou panics again, that's not what he meant. Ugh, fuck. He curses to himself because the words always come out wrong. How do you show affection? No, ugh, you dumbass, that's not what I meant. Kachin, do you mind? It's like 12 a.m. I'm sorry, people are probably asleep. Fuck them. Why do you care so much about people when you're literally on the floor crying? It pisses me off so much that you said what you said. What I said. God. Bakugou picks up Deku's hands from the floor, slowly helping him up to sit back on the couch. He looks over to his puffy eyes, his sharp and stern gaze softening at his messy hair. Bakugou grazes his fingers over his shoulders, leisurely hugging him tightly. He was so glad he was safe. You're such a dumbass, did you really think I was gonna leave you there like this? You'll keep quiet and keep crying till you feel better? Bullshit, Deku. I don't know what made you think that you can't come to me about your problems, but whatever it is, it's not fucking true. That's what I am for you, you dumbass. I'm sorry, I just thought you wouldn't like it because you're probably going to be so annoyed seeing me cry and I. Shut up, I might be rough and mean to everyone, but I'm not going to just let you do that to yourself. Why the hell would I be annoyed? I don't know, I just. What's wrong? You've been coming home so late nowadays, I keep seeing you get distracted in class, and the last straw for me was that you stayed back after school today. You can tell? I'm so offended that you think I don't have the decency to look after my own boyfriend. I'm sorry, I didn't mean that. Bakugou was now bringing him even closer to his chest, making them lay down on the couch as he plays around with the strands of his curly hair. His other hand pats on his back, earning more sniffles from him. I just have been doubting myself lately. Why is that? I recently came back home from my house, right? I met my mum, and she was complaining and crying about how I don't take care of myself enough. It hurts to see her crying because I'm the cause of it. I wanted to make her proud, but I just made her worry about me because I can't take care of myself. I wish I was stronger, I wouldn't have to see that disappointed look. I wanted to train harder, but I kept thinking about things from there and just started spacing out so much. I didn't have the motivation to do things anymore. I still can't control my quirk properly, and it just frustrates me so much that I keep on trying but can't do it. I'm trying so hard but nothing's working. I keep telling myself I'm not good enough for this one for all that's inherited by All Might to me. It's such a big responsibility and I can't even take care of myself for it. How am I going to save other people when I just feel so unworthy of this gift? It makes me so mad because I can't use it properly. And look at everyone. They're constantly doing better than me lately. It makes me so insecure that I can't be as good as them. Look at you, Kakan, you control things so good. You're naturally so ambitious and talented, I wish I had the skills to be like that. He keeps sobbing. Bakugou listened, he never knew Deku felt that way about things. That time when he complained about All Might choosing Izuku over him, he realized it did take up so much pressure to be his inheritor. Bakugou didn't realize how bad it must have made Deku felt. Bakugou hugs him tighter, slowly kissing the top of his forehead as he strokes his back as a sign of reassurance. It hurts him seeing Deku like this. I wish you would have told me sooner about how you felt, because then you wouldn't have to suffer longer. I'm sorry for not approaching you earlier, I completely regret that. Please stop crying. I don't like seeing you cry. It's okay, I'm sure your mum didn't mean it that way. She supports you so much, she's probably your biggest supporter, Deku. And I know, things can be hard because you just started learning and exploring your quirk. You're trying your best and that's what matters the most, okay? Don't be stupid and try exerting what you can't do, don't hurt yourself so much in the process. It also worries me that you don't take care of yourself more often, but hey, I'm here for you. We can go through that together. You don't have to be suffering alone from all of this. Everyone has their bad days, it's normal, I'm sure you'll get back into your own pace. So stop crying already, you're making my hoodie wet. Deku lifts his head up a little and chuckles. His voice was pretty raspy and cracked after the breakdown. I'm sorry. Stop saying sorry. Just know it's okay to have these feelings, okay? You're valid for that. You're so kind today. And I'm not supposed to be. No. It's just super cute seeing you like this. Shut up. Bakugou blushes a little while tucking a strand of his hair behind his ear. He looks at him, examining his facial features. He looked so cute with his red nose and lips, puffed up eyes and cheeks, messy hair. So precious. Bakugou brings him down again to embrace him, going through his hair softly as he said. You're enough, okay, people aren't perfect. Nobody is. If it makes you feel better, talk to me. I'm here. I'm always here for you. Bakugou ends their conversation with a light peck on his neck as they cuddled their way to sleep. The next day. Guys. Mina whispers slowly as she makes a hand sign to come nearer. Do you see this? Ugh, my Bakudiku fangirl self wants to scream loudly crying face. Loudly crying face. Loudly crying face. That's quite wholesome, Mina. I noticed Deku was having a rough time lately, I'm glad everything came together yesterday. What the hell? They look so peaceful, I'm so lonely sad pensive face. Be quiet everyone, let them sleep, they must be really tired. How do you know Ida? I wanted to get a glass of water from the kitchen when I saw them at the lounging room talking to each other at 1 a.m. Let them be, I'll tell Mr. Aizawa an excuse. Everyone left them both sleeping snugly on the couch, smiling to themselves as they leave for class. Oh, cute. I'm single, this isn't fair.